Choosing the right logging configuration can make the difference between finding a performance issue during development or suffering from it on production. But it can also create an overhead that slows down your application. You need to decide which information you need and configure your system accordingly. I therefore prefer to use two different configurations. The development configuration needs to log enough internal information to understand the database interactions, see the number of executed queries, and check the SQL statements. The production configuration should avoid any overhead by logging as few messages as possible. And in addition to the target system, your configuration also depends on the Hibernate version you're using. That's especially the case for your development configuration. Some logging features, like the slow query log, aren't available in older Hibernate versions, and Hibernate 6 changed the names of a few important logging categories. Because of that, I will explain the different log categories and provide you with my recommended logging configurations for development and production when using Hibernate 4, 5, and 6. Hi, I'm Torm Jansen. If you want to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring Data JPA, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. Before we look at the different logging categories and levels, let's have a short look at the logging frameworks supported by Hibernate. Since version 4.0, Hibernate uses the JBoss logging library to write messages to a log file. This library is a logging bridge that integrates different log frameworks. You can see some of the supported frameworks here on the slide. You can, for example, use JBoss Log Manager, Log4j 1 or 2, SLF4j, or JDK Logging. You only need to add your preferred framework to the class path, and the JBoss Logging Library will pick it up. If multiple frameworks are available, it picks the one with the highest priority. The concepts and log categories are the same for all log frameworks, but the configuration files format and log level names can differ. I will show some Log4j2 configuration files in this video. If you are using a different one, please check my corresponding blog article or the documentation of your logging framework. Like all applications and frameworks, Hibernate writes log messages in different categories and log levels. The names of the log levels are defined by your logging framework and define the amount and granularity of the log messages. You can assign a log level to each category. The categories group log messages for specific topics, like executed SQL statements or cache interactions. If you do not specify a log level for a specific category, it will inherit the level from its parent category. The following slides show the most important log categories used by Hibernate. The category org.hibernate contains all messages written by Hibernate. You can use this to analyze unspecific issues or find categories used by Hibernate. Setting this category to a fine log level might create a lot of log output. Hibernate writes all executed SQL statements to the org.hibernate.sql category. You can use it together with org.hibernate.type.descriptor.sql or org.hibernate.orm.jdbc.bind to get more information about the JDBC parameters and results. In version 4 and 5, Hibernate writes the values bound to the JDBC parameters and extracted from the JDBC results to the org.hibernate.type.descriptor.sql category. You should use this category together with org.hibernate.sql to also log the SQL statements. Since version 6, Hibernate writes the values bound to the JDBC parameters to the org.hibernate.orm.jdbc.bind category. You should use it together with org.hibernate.sql to also log the SQL statements. In version 5.4.5, Hibernate introduced the slow query log. It writes all SQL statements that took longer than the configured threshold to the org.hibernate.sql slow category. Hibernate logs the state at flush time of a maximum of 20 entities to the org.hibernate.pretty category. And the information about all second level cache activities are written to the org.hibernate.cache category. If you activated Hibernate's statistics component on your development systems, you can find additional statistics for every executed query in the org.hibernate.stat category. How to get Hibernate to log the executed SQL queries is an often asked question, and the most popular answer on the internet seems to be to set the show_SQL parameter in the persistence.xml to true. But please don't do this. Hibernate provides two ways to activate the logging of the executed SQL queries, and setting the show_SQL parameter to true is the worst one. It has two huge disadvantages. Hibernate writes all executed SQL statements to standard out without using the logging framework. Therefore, it becomes difficult to define the log file which shall contain these specific log messages. Writing to standard out is also most often much slower than using an optimized logging framework. And the persistence.xml is part of a jar file of your application, and you need to open that binary if you want to activate or deactivate the logging of SQL statements. Your logging framework's configuration is most often an external text file that can be easily changed on any system. The better way to activate the logging of executed SQL statements is to set the log level of the org.hibernate.sql category to debug, or the corresponding log level of your log framework. Hibernate will write the SQL statements without any information about the values bound to the JDBC parameters or extracted from the query result. If you also want to get this information, you have to set the log level of org.hibernate.type.descriptor.sql or org.hibernate.orm.jdbc.bind to trace. I will show you an example of this in the next section of this video. The requirements for production and development systems are very different. During development, you need to know what Hibernate is doing in the background, but logging this information slows down the application and is not required in production. I therefore recommend using two different configurations. Let's take a closer look at my recommended logging configuration for development systems first. Hibernate is doing many things for you in the background, which makes it easy to forget that you are still working with a database. But if you want to make sure that your application will perform as you expected, you need to check the number of executed queries and their SQL statements. You need to set the log level for the org.hibernate.sql category to debug to get this information. If you also want to log the useBind parameter values, you also need to set the org.hibernate.type.descriptor.sql category in Hibernate 4 and 5, or the org.hibernate.orm.jdbc.bind category in Hibernate 6 to trace. In addition to that, I prefer to activate Hibernate statistics to get a summary of the most critical metrics at the end of each session. And if you're using Hibernate in at least version 5.4.5, I also recommend activating Hibernate Slow Query Log. If you use this configuration with Hibernate 6, it will write a log file that looks very similar to this one. It shows the Hibernate messages for a session in which I persist two new author entities, update one of them afterward, and selected all authors with a given last name. If you're using the configuration variation for Hibernate 4 and 5, you might want to deactivate the logging of the org.hibernate.type.descriptor.sql category. This will remove the log messages showing the bound and extracted parameter values. These are often the majority of the written log messages, and there are so many of them that the log gets hard to read. Okay, let's talk about my recommended configuration for production systems next. As long as you don't need to analyze an issue in production, you should log as little information as possible. Now, this can be done for all Hibernate versions by setting all Hibernate-related log categories to error. You should also make sure that the Hibernate statistics component and the slow query log are deactivated. Let's summarize this video. Hibernate supports several logging providers, and you can pick the one you prefer by adding it to the class path of your application. The log messages are grouped into different categories, and you can activate or deactivate them by assigning a log level for each category. Writing log messages and collecting the required information takes some time. You should therefore switch off all unnecessary log messages in your production configuration. The development configuration should activate debug logging for some crucial categories like org.hibernate.sql And I most often also activate Hibernate statistics to find potential performance issues as soon as possible. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate and JPA, you should join the Persistence Hub. It gives you access to all my video courses, including one about Spring Data JPA and another one about Hibernate performance tuning, 2 monthly Q&A calls, monthly coding challenges, a community of like-minded developers, and regular expert sessions. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!